This is how liberty dies. With thunderous applause.
They're spying at me. First thing. Second thing, Michael McCall, right. Who is, you know, the leader of, I would say, the neocons in the House, kind of low-key neocons, but neocons. What I got into an argument with him once last year on the phone. He told somebody that I was a Russian agent or something, and I was outraged. So I called him on the phone, and I, you know, I used bad language. I was really mad, and he said, "Whoa, whoa, whoa! I just got that. You know, that's what the intel briefers told me, that you were working for Russia." And I said, "That's what the intel briefers told you? You believe your fucking intel brief? Like, how old are you, son? You know, I'm from DC. My dad was in this world. Like, you don't. You're being manipulated by your intel briefers."
In the day, in the age of the internet, a lot of misleading information is dumped out onto the public, and a lot of it's intentional. A lot of it. You have Tucker Carlson talking about the way DC works. Okay, that's how pop culture journalism works. Okay, and it doesn't matter if it's Deadline Hollywood or if it's a YouTube channel, okay? And the problem with non-professional journalists is the fact of the matter is, excuse me, they aren't judicious with their information. A lot of them just shotgun everything out there. They're inconsistent with their judgment calls. Okay. And that in of itself is misleading because they don't know what they're talking about. All right. And that is basically the bottom line. When you've got someone like Kathleen Kennedy, who is fighting to stay relevant in a franchise she doesn't like, she doesn't like Star Wars. She's not a Star Wars fan. She's going to do something drastic to hurt it on the way out the door. And a lot of YouTube channels unknowingly are helping her. All right, I see it in comments. "Well, I don't care. I'm not coming back until blah, 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 and blah, blah." Look, stop having conditions, okay? All right. First off, let's go back and Corporation 101. Corporations are made up of people. Those people are can either be jackasses like we have right now, or they can be decent and want to make money. Okay. You know, right now we've got a bunch of jackasses at Lucasfilm who are terrified that they're next on the chopping block, and they want to make their own money. I mean, Pablo, he wants to make his own money, but he doesn't care about Disney's bottom line. And that's his problem. It used to be when you hired people for a job and it didn't matter what they were doing, regardless if they were waitresses at a diner or senior vice presidents at, you know, the Ford Corporation, Ford Motor Company, they would do their best for the company and get rewarded for doing their best. Now it's, I want what's mine and my bonus, and I want to be able to do what I want to do, even if it hurts the company's bottom line, because billionaires should be disappeared and mulched. That's who's working for Disney right now, okay, at Lucasfilm, okay. What they don't understand is they're hurting the bigger picture, okay. They're hurting the bigger picture, and they're doing things in public under the radar that hurts the bigger picture, too.
Do it.
The dark side of the Force is a pathway to many abilities some consider to be unnatural.
Kathleen Kennedy did tell Bob Iger and Bob Chapek, "This nonsense will stop or I will burn it all down." She said that. Okay. And it's very interesting to me that it seems like it's happening right now. And that was an old Doomcock rumor that look, a lot of people in this will go with the most recent thing, and they'll forget what they said before. Okay. And what he said, and this is what he said before. This is what he said. She said, "This nonsense will end, or I will burn it all down." Okay. So how does she do that? She knows that Jon Favreau offered Daisy Ridley a chance to close out the Rey story in the Ahsoka, right? In Ahsoka season 2. And instead, Kathy circumvented him and did an end around with a Rey movie that no one wants. Okay. This Rey movie is being supposedly, it's not going to happen, being directed by a woman who's never directed anything in her life beyond documentaries. And she's a woke bitch shill. Okay. Charmaine Obaid Chinoy, who has never done a big tentpole movie. It's supposedly now, since Damon Lindelof said he was basically told to leave, written by a guy named Stephen Knight, Peaky Blinders, who is in the middle of writing a bio of Shakespeare. So, and this guy is a notoriously slow writer. Okay, so how is it possible that he's going to be able to do this and have a script by Cannes Film Festival, which is going to be in a couple of weeks? You know, I mean, we're really not that far away from big things happening, okay? Then we have The Acolyte, or The Trashalite, as I like to call it, trotting out Leslie Headland, Harvey Weinstein's former personal assistant, who cried about how Star Wars saved her, la 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 la, just making a fool of herself. It's fake tears. I don't care what she says. They're being sued because they basically lied to a line producer who's got connections to people like Tom Hanks, Paul Giamatti, to Bob Iger himself, okay? And, you know, you've got, again, misinformation coming from Lucasfilm itself on the state of The Acolyte. They have told the Black Pill Blobs that it's almost finished filming. And a month ago, they were only in the middle of filming episode 4. So that must be some really fast fucking filming. Okay, I'm literally speechless. Anybody would take that as truth without stepping back and saying, what? Wait a second. You know, they're being sued. Okay. In fact, it looks like now that Ms. McCarthy's lawyer feels very strongly that it might just be a sizzle reel like we've suspected for a long fucking time. Okay. Yet, you know, taking information from people who don't have the best wishes for Star Wars, for Disney, for the fandom, for Jon Favreau and Dave Filoni, for truth, taking what Pablo and the rest of these, because look, this Black Pill shit is just started. This is a misinformation campaign. Just like the misinformation campaign, look, when you've got 50 intelligence leaders signing an affidavit saying that the Hunter Biden laptop wasn't real, and yet it was real, the FBI had it, that's the same fucking thing going on right here. And it's the Trashalite. It's the Trashalite, okay? And it's really interesting how this information is being manipulated, and people who know better believe it, okay? Now let's go into the other thing. Okay, this is the thing that really makes me mad. Jon Favreau and Dave Filoni. Jon Favreau and Dave Filoni don't hate each other. Dave Filoni is not trying to usurp Ahsoka. Okay, Ahsoka is, he's the showrunner for it. John is helping him with that. Dave wrote all of the episodes, and that's fine. That's not usurping, you dumbasses. So where did they get this from? Well, some of it was made up, like when Paz Vizsla sacrificed himself in the last episode of Mandalorian. Dave, Jon Favreau is just basically saying he's killing off his character so he can leave. That is fucking stupid. Put down the Tullamore Dew for crying out loud. All right, stop it. Stop it. Just stop it. No, that's not what happened. Go back and watch Clone Wars and Rebels, and you'll understand why Paz Vizsla did that. Okay? You know, I looked at this season of Mandalorian and realized how many people who decided they didn't like it have never actually watched anything else but the movies. And they think they're Star Wars fans. Unbelievable. Jon Favreau has the season two of Ahsoka in the system. They're talking about already getting ready to film Mandalorian season four. And if and when the strike ends in October, hopefully by then it'll be over. And that's it. That's what's going on. Look, this stuff, this Favreau stuff, Filoni versus Favreau, Acolyte being almost done filming, which is literally the stupidest thing I've ever heard in my life. God, what a lie. What a fucking lie. And the Rey movie are social fake news, okay? And it's being spread far and wide by the Black Pill blobs and by Black Pill channels. Because they don't know how to discern, again, intelligence. Again, why did I use what Tucker Carlson said? Because that's what's going on here now. All right. I feel like Tucker calling people up saying, that's not what's going on. You're being manipulated. Okay. And honest to God, when I hear this stuff, I can't believe people are falling for it when obviously, guys, it is apparent to me that it's fake, all right? We don't know what's going on, okay? Look, they're not going to talk about making any movies right now as long as the strike is going on. So that's, and Kathleen Kennedy walking out, poker-faced, stony-faced of Iger's office, not saying a word at the office, tells me that she was absolutely ripped apart, okay? That's what that tells me. This, look, her not feeling confident enough to tell people or to cry on people's shoulders, trying to get her narcissistic supply upped, tells me that she had the shit scared out of her and that any tension coming from the office is coming from the president of Lucasfilm's office. Okay, that's what that says. Okay, now, when Tucker goes, the guy he was talking about got his information from the National Security Agency about Tucker being a Russian agent. I look at people and said, this is exactly what is going on with the Black Pill channels. They're being manipulated. They're being used to help Kathleen Kennedy on the way out the door destroy Star Wars, ruin any hope of Jon Favreau has of fixing what she broke. And the reason why she's doing it is because she knows the sequel trilogy is being retconned. It's going to disappear. And she knows the High Republic is going to be canceled the moment she steps out the door, okay? And she cannot handle the reality that she failed, okay? Because like a narcissist, she believed all the good things people said about her, even when she was being lied to her face, okay? And now it's coming back in spades to haunt her, and she's spewing it at everybody through her intermediaries, Pablo, and anybody else who's got a black pill ear, okay? And her messengers like Jason Ward, Star Wars Explained, Star Wars Meg, etc. Okay? This is Steph signing out. I'll see you around the galaxy.